Let's get into three tips or three things that you can actually do during an active shooter situation. This is what we fear, we security professionals. This is the one threat that we fear the most, is that lone wolf, that crazy guy with a weapon who pledges allegiance to any particular group and wants to create massive damage. So this is the fear of security professionals. This is what's going on. And you know, as you know, the traditional targets, the embassies, the Department of Defense and so forth, they are hard to target. So these guys are going out after the mass public venues and so forth. We saw it in Paris, and now we see it again in Orlando, Florida. So three tips, let's get into it right away. Number one, you hear shots being fired. The first tip, the first thing you should do is run. Okay, it doesn't sound too Braveheart, but it is really the first thing you should do is run. Now, once you're outside, once you're safe, then you can start thinking about warning other people, about taking action such as calling the authorities, about assessing the situation and so forth. But number one thing is for you to run. Now, let's say you're caught up in the situation and you cannot run for whatever reason. You got shocked. You didn't do anything. Now you can't run. You don't, and you hear the gunfire closer. Second thing you should do, number two, is to hide, find refuge, a safe haven of some sort, and barricade yourself, all right? Take that second, take a deep breath. This is the new reality. I gotta deal with this. Hide, okay? Again, not too Mel Gibson-like, not too Braveheart-like, but it is the second most effective thing you can do. The third thing you should do, now let's say you couldn't run, you couldn't get out the way, you failed to hide as well. Now you're one-on-one, this guy's coming in. What you gotta do is fight. Fight for your life. Fight for everybody that you love. Fight, all right? Get other people to help you as well. So once again, number one, run. Number two, hide. Number three, fight. Now if you can't do any of these things, then your chances of survival are very low, okay? Once again, you know, this message is for expats, for travelers, for people around the world that don't want to feel victims to this threat, this barbaric threat that's worldwide. Empower yourself with security awareness. Take the pledge that you are responsible for your security, and you know, go out there and live an empowering life. Don't let this stop you from traveling, from living your life, from living your dreams. So that's my message for you at Davis Security. My thoughts and prayers are with the family, the families of the victims of Orlando, and those that are trying to fight for their life as well, and everyone worldwide who is trying to overcome this barbaric threat. So I wish you a safe and joyful week. Take care.